This is a gold medal problem. As I told you, if you're able to solve this 100% correctly, give yourself a big pat on your back, because it really requires you to think a little more deeply than you normally used to. So what this problem is asking is, it's asking us to write the algorithm to divide the larger number by the smaller one. If it is simply 5 and 10, it's easy because 10 by 5 is 5. The problem comes when zeros come into picture. So whenever you're solving a problem by an algorithm, try to think of all the possible input or data values that a user can give. Based on that, it is very easy to develop the logic. So let us say I have two variables whose names are numA and numB. Now, if both of them happen to be 0, it is a problem because 0 by 0 has no answer in maths. So this is the first case, which is a problem where both number A and number B are 0. This is also a problem because 5 is greater than 0, but I cannot divide a positive number by 0 because the answer to that is also unknown. Then what about the next? If number A is 0 and number B is 5, this is also a problem because 5 by 0 again does not have any answers in maths. Then if I go to the next data, 1 is 0 and 1 is minus 10, this is not a problem. The reason being, 0 is bigger than minus 10, 0 upon minus 10, the answer is 0. Let's take a look at one more. Minus 10, 0, again not a problem because 0 upon minus 10 is again 0. 10 upon 20, absolutely not a problem. It is going to be 2. Minus 20 upon 10, again not a problem because 10 upon minus 20 is going to be minus 0.5, I believe. Then 10 upon minus 20, again not a problem. So we need to take care of logic which deals with these first three fellows immediately. So we are going to use the if, else if, else if, else if here, but it is very simple how we are going to write the logic. I am going to read number A comma number B. If number A equal to 0 and number B equal to 0, I am going to say division by 0 and stop. Else if number A greater than 0 and number B equal to 0, then divide by 0, error. Else if number B greater than 0 and number A equal to 0, again divide by 0, error. Else if number A greater than number B, then divide number A by number B, else divide number B by number A. So let's try to go ahead and proceed to write the logic. So the first step is, we are going to write start number A, number B, and read number A and number B. So here I have shown you all the possible input values, and the ones in red indicate the problem input values we need to give special attention to. Once we read num A and num B, the first condition is, if number A is equal to 0 and number B is equal to 0, this is a problem. I'm going to write 0 by 0 division and I'm going to halt. Then what I'm going to do here is, I am going to now check if number A is greater than 0 and number B is equal to 0. This is also a problem case. So in this problem case, what I am doing here is, again I am saying divide by 0, error. Now I have taken care of two major problems. I have still one more issue where number B is greater than 0 and number A is equal to 0. This is again a problem for me. So I am writing divide by 0, error. The next case is quite simple. Either A has to be greater than B or B has to be greater than A, or both have to be equal. So in this case, what is going to happen here is, if A is greater than B, the result is number A divided by number B. Finally, either A has to be equal to B or B has to be greater than A. In that case, this else condition will take care of that particular issue also. So if you take a look at this particular logic, it will deal with every possible situation, both positive, both negative, both zeros, one positive, one zero, all those cases it will comfortably deal. But We don't trust our logic until we have run through the data. So first what we will do is we will take 0 and 0. Number A is 0, number B is 0. Both are 0 and condition says both are 0. Number A is 0 and number B is 0. I am going to write 0 by 0 division and then I am going to come here and stop. Next is 5 and 0. This condition is false. A is greater than 0, B is equal to 0. So division by 0, error, and stop. 0 and 5. This is false. This is false. Number B is 5, which is greater than 0. Number A is 0. So again, divide by 0, error, and I'm going to stop. Now 0 and minus 10. 0 minus 10. This condition is false. This is false. This is also false. 0 is greater than minus 10. So result is going to be 0 upon minus 10, which is going to be 0. Print 0 and then it's going to stop. For all the other values, you can take a look at the description, create as many value tables you want, run through the logic, and then you will get a really clear idea why this particular program works in all cases. Once again, if you have done this problem, super, excellent. But provided you have taken care of every particular data value, I would doubt more than one or two would be actually able to get it correctly, or probably none.